ILTV Plus, your news from Israel and more 24/7. Start your free trial today. Subscribe at ILTV.tv and watch from any device. Many doubted the day would ever come, even in the hours leading up to the meetings itself. But world powers taking the first step Monday towards renewing JCPOA nuclear agreements with Iran. Negotiations in Vienna resuming after a months-long suspension, and parties to the talks reporting progress, just not necessarily towards curbing Iran's nuclear program.
Over the recent months, the Iranian nuclear program has advanced, and at the same time, the United States are imposing the same sanctions. Nothing has changed from the previous administration. And that situation points in the direction of that we have to bring JCPOA back to life, both for nuclear commitments and for the benefit of the Iranian population.
به نظر من خودش یک دستاورد قابل توجه هست که همه کشورهای عضو گروه 4 به علاوه 1 به مطالبه به حق جمهوری اسلامی ایران تن دادند و بر اون تاکید و تصریح کردند که باید ابتدا در واقع وضعیت تحریم‌های غیرقانونی رژیم آمریکا علیه مردم ما روشن بشه و بعد از اون نسبت به سایر موارد بحث و بررسی و تصمیم گیری بشه.
Supposed nuclear negotiations back on the table in Vienna. After stonewalling for months, Iran finally returning to talks opposite the P5+1 powers and indirectly opposite the U.S. Just as Israeli officials predicting, however, Iran coming to the table with a very focused agenda, to first receive without any guarantees of reciprocity. Iranian officials demanding that long before the nuclear or any other issues are discussed, the United States must lift its sanctions and guarantee not to impose new sanctions nor reimpose previously lifted ones.
Today, Iran will be arriving at negotiations in Vienna with a clear goal: to end sanctions in exchange for almost nothing. Iran won't just keep its nuclear program. From today, they'll be getting paid for it.
They will play for time, earn billions from the removal of sanctions, continue to deceive the world, and covertly advance their nuclear program. This is what they have done in the past, and this is what they will do this time as well.
Iran deserves no rewards, no bargain deals, and no sanctions relief in return for their brutality. I call upon our allies around the world, do not give in to Iran's nuclear blackmail.
Meantime, Israel sharing intelligence with the United States, the UK, and other world powers party to the talks in Vienna, showing that Iran already capable of enriching uranium to 90% or weapons grade within weeks. Iran also already amassing a stockpile with hundreds of kilos of uranium enriched to upwards of 60%, whereas the JCPOA caps enrichment at just 3.67%, which is all that's really necessary for civilian use. That said, not everyone is impressed by Israel's intel, with Russia and China leaning more towards getting the United States to ease sanctions. Those who are playing hardball with Iran, however, or at least harder, so far include the UK and to a lesser degree the US. United States envoy on Iran Robert Malley saying that the West won't fall for Iran's stalling tactics again, and UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson supporting Israel's rights to defend itself should talks fail, arguing that while talks in Vienna could work, Iran must, more than anything, change its overall behavior.